Lumalapit na po ang eleksyon. At napapansin niyo po, marami na pong mga political advertisements sa ating mga television. Natural lamang yung mga naghahangad na mahalal sa darating na election, they want to project themselves as the best candidate. They want themselves to be known by as many people as possible. Politicians generally love the adulation and the attention of the crowd. And this adulation and admiration, they take advantage of them in a way that this would be translated into votes during elections. Sa ating pong ebanghelyo, maliwanag ng ating Panginoong Kristo ay hindi politiko. Can you imagine? The whole town was looking for him. They want him to stay. It is reminiscent of that incident wherein Jesus multiplied the bread and fed the 5,000. And the townspeople were practically begging him to stay. And they want to make him king. But Jesus walked away from them. In the gospel today, it tells us, he said, to the other towns also I must proclaim the good news of the kingdom of God, because for this purpose I have been sent. Ano ba ang ibig sabihin nito? That the good news must be spread. It must be shared. It must be proclaimed. The good news of God's goodness, love, and forgiveness, and healing. It has to be spread, to be shared. People were hungry for the word of God. That's why listeners to Jesus exclaimed, "We have never heard anyone speak like this before." And so Jesus wanted to move to the other towns to spread the fragrance of love. It must be spread around. On one occasion, Jesus said, "No secret remains hidden. It will be laid bare in the open. What you hear in closed door, what you hear in the dark, proclaim it in the light. Proclaim it at mountain tops." Kasi nung kapanahunan ng ating Panginoong Kristo, hindi naman lahat ay katanggap-tanggap ang kanyang mga pangangaral. The scribes and the Pharisees wanted to eradicate him, wanted to kill him. And so sometimes, he and his disciples would preach in secret, in closed doors. But Jesus said, what you hear in the dark, proclaim it in the light. Proclaim it at mountaintops. In other words, God's love, the good news must be spread all over the world. Kaya nga, ang ating simbahan ay tinatawag na Catholic, Apostolic Church, Universal Church. We have unity in terms of teachings and worship. Everybody is welcome. It is not a secret society. We take inspiration from John 3:16, for God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, so that all those who believe in Him may not perish but will have eternal life. All, everybody is invited. That's why the church is inclusive, universal. She wants to embrace everybody, universal and diverse, coming from different cultures, different cultural backgrounds, different race, because God's love is for everybody. And how do we spread this good news? We ourselves should become embodiments, conduits of God's love. That's why Jesus said, "You are the light of the world. A light should not be hidden under a bushel basket. It should be put on a lampstand for all to see." The best way, the most effective, and the most efficient way of spreading God's love is through Christians who practice compassion. Yung masama, yung mabaho, yung basura, yan ay tinatago, tinatakpan. Kaya kung minsan yung nag-imbestiga ng masamang gawain, mga katiwalian, kuminsan sa ating gobyerno, itong gawain ito ay mahirap, sapagkat ikaw, kuminsan ikaw pa ang ipapalabas na masama. Ikaw ay mapapahamak, because evil deeds should be kept in the dark. But goodness, God's goodness, the goodness in our hearts should not remain there. If it is really good news, then it has to be shared. You know, we should take inspiration from our frontliners, those in the medical profession, nurses, doctors, caregivers, those who are working, risking their lives in hospitals, because they are selfless. They forget about themselves, their own safety, in order to save lives. That is exactly how we spread God's goodness. We call them heroes, mga bayani. Hinahangaan natin sila, pero napakalungkot. Very sad na itong mga tinatawag nating bayani ay nagmamakaawa pa sa ating gobyerno, sa ating pamahalaan, upang sila ibigyan ng kanilang emergency allowance. Sana hindi totoo yung mga napapabalita na kung minsan yung funding na dapat mapunta sa kanila o gagamitin sa pagsugpo ng pandemya ay nauwi lamang sa katiwalian. Sana hindi totoo. Because how can you reconcile billions of pesos being siphoned if it is true by a chosen few? And yet, we cannot give the emergency allowance of our frontliners. Hindi ba kayo nagtataka na excited ang karamihan dahil September na, malapit ng December, sapagkat tuwing Disyembre, it seems that everybody has this goodwill to share. We become more generous, more forgiving. In other words, that's the spirit of Jesus. The spirit of Christmas is spreading the good news, spreading God's love, spreading God's goodness. Kaya dito sa ating ebanghelyo, ay sa ating unang pagbasa, tuwang-tuwa si San Pablo sa kanyang mga sulat sa mga taga-Kulosas at sabi niya, Of these you have already heard through the word of truth, the gospel that has come to you. Just as in the whole world, it is bearing fruit and growing. From the day you heard of it and came to know the grace of God in truth. Ito ang katotohanan na ibinunyag ng ating Panginoong Kristo at sabi niya, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me. Goodness, love, compassion, forgiveness are beautiful words, but they should not only remain words, empty words. Dapat isabuhay natin. And it's only when we follow Jesus, that is what He meant by the truth will set you free. Compared to someone who has done evil deeds, merong tinatago, merong pinagtatakpan, tinatago ang masamang gawain. He does everything in order that the evil deeds would not be uncovered. Kung minsan yung mister laging nagsisinungaling sa misis upang hindi malaman ang kanyang pagtataksil or being unfaithful. The evil deeds that we do, yung masama ay itinatago, yung mabuti, yung katotohanan, yung pagsunod natin sa kalooban ng Diyos, dapat ito'y ipagmalaki, ipakita sa madla. Kaya that's why the prayer of Saint Francis is very appropriate in relation to the gospel tonight. Saint Francis said, "Lord, make me an instrument of thy peace and love. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand." Jesus, in the gospel today, wants us to spread the good news all over the world. That's why He said, "To the other towns also, I must proclaim the good news of the kingdom of God, because for this purpose I have been sent."